Friends, at the outset, my greetings to all of you on this historic day, which marks the completion of 25 years of mobile telephony in India. In the journey of these 2.5 decades, beginning 1995, we have witnessed phenomenal growth, adoption of new technologies, penetration and proliferation of mobiles across the length and breadth of India. Mobile telecommunications has become central to India's development story. All of you who are or have been stakeholders in this important journey deserve congratulations for all your efforts, relentless pursuit of goals, and remarkable achievements. I also take this opportunity to recognize and applaud the stellar role played by the telecommunications sector in keeping India connected during the lockdown and restrictions necessitated by our fight against COVID-19. It is the telecommunications networks which enabled each one of us to remain in touch with our friends and relatives. No flights, no trains, no road transport. What connected us was telecom. Healthcare workers and doctors, law enforcement agencies, essential services, government authorities, among others, were able to deliver effectively due to the voice, data, and video connectivity enabled by telecommunication networks. Despite the surge in data consumption, and we were very closely monitoring how data consumption was increasing, I am happy to note the Indian telecommunications networks did not fail us even once during this period. I recall the mid-90s when the mobile phones being used by us were heavy, looked clumsy, and were essentially used for voice communication in a mobile setting. The rates per calls were unaffordable, especially for roaming calls. Both incoming and outgoing calls were charged. But that is history. Since that period, what we have achieved appears to be unimaginable. The mobile density in India has now become over 85%. The data usage per month per subscriber is over 10.5 GB, perhaps one of the highest in the world. And the cost of data is perhaps the lowest in the world at just about a quarter of a dollar. With fast adoption of 4G technology, we also witness a great leap in better quality of service with high speed of downloads and high quality voice, data, and video connectivity. The telecom infrastructure industry has also fared with distinction. India has led the world with the concept of sharing of towers. Today, the number of towers in India is over 6 lakhs and is rapidly expanding. Mobile phones have become both vital and central in our daily lives. The very role of mobile phones has changed in the last 25 years. From an alternative to fixed line voice communication, today, mobile phones are the backbone of e-governance, e-commerce, value-added services, and most important, empowerment of citizens. The mobiles today are without doubt a necessity. They are a basic requirement in the list of essentials: water, food, fresh air, followed by access to and availability of mobile and smartphone coverage. The internet and broadband revolution rides on telecommunication networks. Smartphones are our link to the world, and we all use mobiles all the time as we travel and get on with our daily life. Friends, while we have every reason to be proud of our success, we must also realize that the period ahead is full of challenges. Telecommunications is capital intensive and requires continual investment in maintenance and renewal of networks, as also for adoption of new technologies. This in turn entails capital infusion. India also requires larger network of wireline communication and wireline broadband. The tower density has to be majorly enhanced. Fiber use per capita must increase. Towers need to be fiberized. FTTH connections and internet lease line communication should proliferate. The rural areas, which have shown huge appetite for data consumption, require better telecommunication connectivity. There should not be and cannot be a digital divide between regions, between urban and rural areas, and between haves and have-nots. The right-of-way issues require resolution. Certain reforms in telecom policy will obviously have a salutary impact for the telecom industry. While the telecom policy has evolved from the year 1994, 1999, 2012, and in 2018, we now have a very futuristic national digital communications policy. Concerted efforts are a must to achieve the goals and objectives of this policy. Provision of broadband for all, enhancing contribution of digital communications in GDP and employment, increasing our ranking in the Global ICT Development Index are some of the challenges which we need to address. We also need to prepare, invest, and be ready for reaping the benefits of 5G technology opportunities and applications across all sectors, including health, education, agriculture, disaster management, industry, commerce, etc. Enhancement of our capabilities and capacities in the core ICT sector must be a focus area. Honorable Prime Minister has already focused our attention to Atmanirbhar Bharat. It is our belief that with active efforts of all stakeholders, the telecommunications sector in India will emerge stronger and meet the expectations and aspirations of propelling India to a higher trajectory of growth with major enhancement in the quality of life of all citizens. On this occasion, I wish to reiterate the constructive support of the government for realizing the existing and emerging potential of the telecommunications sector and mobile telephones. Jai Hind.